So, Havoc Squad. The best of the best. Can't say I'm thrilled about the demotion, but it's an honor to be here, sir.
I realize the circumstances weren't ideal, but I'm glad you're with us, Jorgen.
A spot in Havoc was the least they could do. 4 years at the Academy, 7 years in the field, decorations, commendations. Would have been captain soon if Command hadn't hung me out to dry.
We both know Tavis's defection wasn't your fault.
Tell that to the brass when they need a scapegoat. But hey, water under the bridge. Command put me in Havoc to help you find Tavis, and I intend to do just that. I've hunted Imperials from one side of the galaxy to the next. Used to command the Deadeyes, finest sniper squad in the Republic.
I'm not familiar with that outfit.
No? Maybe I'll tell you about them sometime. I reviewed your service record before that ZR-57 op. Been meaning to discuss it with you. Says you served in the Outer Rim. Knew a lot of good men who fought out there. Heard it was brutal. Warfare like that can change a person. Make them reckless. Unstable.
You saw how I handled things on Ord Mantell. I know what I'm doing.
Taking on that SEP army single-handedly showed guts, not leadership. When I signed on with the Deadeyes, my CO was Lieutenant Vorn. Certified war hero, as decorated as they come. When he gave an order, we trusted it, followed it to the letter. A squad needs that kind of commitment to operate effectively.
I expect you to give me that same level of dedication.
I always give 100%. That's not the issue. Havoc Squad is the Republic's most elite outfit. We tackle the missions no one else can handle. Traitor or no, Tavis is a tough act to follow. You think you're up to it?
My record speaks for itself.
I'll admit, you've seen and done more than most soldiers your age. You've got confidence and plenty of raw talent. Maybe you'll pull this off. You think Havoc will start shaping into an actual squad soon?
I'll recruit more soldiers as soon as I find some Havoc-worthy candidates.
Makes sense. Once this unit starts growing, people's expectations of us, of you, are only gonna get bigger. That CO post could get real heavy, real quick.
Someone needs to run Havoc Squad.
Commanding a squad is no cakewalk. Nothing worse than having to choose between the success of the mission and the lives of your men. That said, a leader can't be soft on his troops. Coddling your men will only get them killed.
You've got a point. I'll keep it in mind.
I'm sure you'll do fine. You've gotten us this far. Inventory report, sir. Food and medical supplies all look good, but our munitions are getting low. Thought we'd have enough to last us a year. Already requisitioned command for more. Guess I shouldn't be too surprised. See more action one day with Havoc than you see in a month with the Deadeyes.
What kind of work did you do for the Deadeyes?
We mainly ran decapitation strikes. Neutralized enemy commanders before Republic offensive. Left the opposition leaderless, disorganized. Sometimes, we'd camp outside the enemy's base for weeks, waiting for a clear shot. Eventually, we'd hit our target, pull out, let the ground pounders mop up.
You must have chalked up quite a kill count.
Over 24 confirmed. Eventually, I was offered a promotion and a post on Ord Mantell. I took it. Smart move career-wise. More men, more responsibility. But I wasn't interested in fighting separatists.
Must have been an awkward transition.
One day I'm picking off Imperial brass, the next I'm pacifying mobs of angry seps. After my transfer, command of the Deadeyes fell to my XO, Torv. Smart kid. A little green, but the potential was there.
If he learned from you, I'm sure he's a fine officer.
Only so much a person can be taught about leadership. You've either got what it takes, or you don't. Come to think of it, I haven't been in contact with the Deadeyes for a while. I should find out where they're stationed. Catch up. Sir, you should know. General Vander contacted me. Said he'd talk it over with the brass and finagled a way to get me back on Ord Mantell. Offered me my old post. A promotion and command of their operations there. Pretty sweet deal overall.
I hope you turned him down. You're a part of Havoc Squad now.
You think I'd head back to some backwater planet like Ord Mantell? Fact is, I've been hitting the Empire harder than ever since I joined Havoc Squad. I'd enlist to win medals or promotions. I enlisted to protect the Republic. To prove my people have a place here.
Glad you're finally warming up to your assignment.
It's growing on me.
We already lost one home to the Mandalorians. I'm not about to let the Empire take another.
Bad news, sir. I just received a dispatch from command. It's my old sniper squad, the Deadeyes. They've been captured. Happened during a routine officer hunt. Somehow the imps got the drop on them and rounded up the entire unit. Careless.
How long have the Deadeyes been in Imperial custody?
Weeks. More than enough time to be marched in front of a firing squad. Look, something about this doesn't sit right with me. The Deadeyes' area of operation was on Nar Shaddaa. That's hot territory. Neutral ground. They shouldn't have had any business operating there.
You think there's more going on here?
Can't say yet. I need to know what happened to the Deadeyes. And if they're still alive. Missions on Nar Shaddaa are usually greenlit by the SIS. With your permission, I'd like to meet with them. See what they know.
Get a hold of Jonas Balker. He may be able to help us.
Your call. We'll rendezvous at the dive he hangs out in. With any luck, he'll have something for us.
You're early. Haven't even had time to order us up a round. So, how's that 4X unit treating you? Racking up plenty of kills, I hope.
The Deadeyes. Balker, what do you know?
He's right. We didn't come for small talk.
Fair enough. I dug up what info I could, but frankly, there isn't much to report. Far as I can tell, the Deadeyes tried to off some Imperial big shot. Things went south, and they got themselves captured.
We both know the SIS has more intel than that.
There's more at stake here than you know. We're on the verge of an incident. The Imperials are out for blood, so the Republic is distancing itself from the operation. I shouldn't even be talking to you about all this. Those boys are on their own.
These are Republic soldiers, sir. Good men. All of them.
If the Republic won't do anything, then Havoc Squad will.
Look, I know this stinks. But my hands are tied on this one. I've got major players breathing down my neck. Otherwise, I'd tell you to investigate that prison the Imperials set up in Shadowtown.
Now we're getting somewhere.
You didn't hear this from me. Now, rumor has it, and I'm just talking here, that the Imperials built themselves a makeshift prison not too far from here. That's where they dump any local riffraff that get out of line. Could be they took the Deadeyes there.
Start. We'll look into it.
The less I know, the better. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got an alibi to work on. Remember, this meeting never happened.
No sign of them here. Balker must have sent us on a wild... Wait. I may have something. It's an outgoing holo message. Recent.
This is Captain Titch, confirming the details for outgoing prisoner transfer 993B. We've got three Gamorrean trespassers, a couple of spice peddlers, and our catch of the day, the legendary Deadeyes.
At least we know they're alive.
Or they were at the time of this transmission.
As per protocol, we've split the Deadeyes up and transferred them to off-world labor camps. I've encrypted the coordinates for their designated camps into this transmission. Those scum can spend their remaining years working off their debt.
Message ends there. Guess the imps don't make things quick for their POWs. Lucky us.
That doesn't mean we have time to waste.
Agreed. I'll download those coordinates ASAP. The encryption here is good. Too good. I can't crack it. Looks like we may need Balker's services again.
Off the hollow with a very angry Imperial diplomat. Apparently, some Republic troopers broke into the Imperial Detention Center.
Hey, I just went to Hari's for a drink. They got a new waitress there. Real looker.
Don't get cute with me, Balker. You know something.
Is this a bad time?
On the contrary. Now I know exactly where to stick my foot. Senior Agent Zane, SIS. That little stunt you pulled ruined any chance we had of negotiating the Deadeyes' safe return.
Check your facts, Zane. The Imperials already shipped them off-world.
It's Senior Agent Zane, thank you. And storming an Imperial facility, guns blazing, it makes things worse. Your involvement ends now. Clear?
Our involvement ends when the Deadeyes are free.
Then you can tell your CO to expect a little love note from me. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got an Imperial ambassador to mollify. I trust you'll see yourselves off my planet.
What were you thinking coming back here? I told you I couldn't be connected to any of this.
We found some encrypted coordinates in the prison central computer. We think they'll tell us where the Deadeyes are.
We were going to see if you could help us, but after that outburst...
Yeah, I'd rather keep my job, thanks. Look, a friend in Signal Intelligence owes me a favor. I'll put you in contact with him. He may be able to make something of those coordinates. It's the best I can do.
Thanks for your help on this one.
Sure thing.
I'll connect with Balker's contact once we get back to the ship. I'll report if I hear anything.
Got a problem, sir. Weapons malfunction. I had a couple misfires during that prison run. I think the barrel might be out of whack. Not surprising, given all the action we've seen. With your permission, I'd like to inspect the rest of the squad's ordnance. Make sure everything's up to code.
Way to think ahead, Jorgen.
That's what I do. When you're sniping enemies from 800 meters, any imperfection in the blaster can ruin your shot.
You hit targets from that far? You're good.
Part of the job, sir. Permission to speak freely, sir.
Permission granted.
Dorne's a fine soldier, but... come on. We both know that exo position had my name all over it. Why would you sabotage my career even further? Is it personal? Or did you just forget that I used to be a lieutenant?
This isn't about you. Alara just has more of what I'm looking for in an XO.
Fine. You can't see officer material when it's right in front of you, that's your business. Sir. Well, the search is officially underway. I transmitted those coordinates we picked up to Balkar's contact in SIGINT. Won't be long before we find out where the Deadeyes are. Well, look at that. Hey, you, Gav?
You know, you really ought to start encrypting your communications. Finding your frequency was child's play.
You're crossing the line, Zane. Stay out of our business.
I was about to say the same to you. I'll just leave you with a friendly suggestion. Walk away.
That's smug. Why is he so interested in the Deadeyes? In any case, he knows about Balker's contact at SIGINT. We'll have to find someone else to decrypt those coordinates.
I'd like to see Zane outmaneuver General Garza.
Now you're talking. I'll bring the General up now.
This is General Garza. What can I do for you, Havoc?
We've got a problem, General.
I don't like you going off mission, Captain. But then again, I don't like SIS snoops meddling in military affairs either. Send me the coordinates. I'll get our people working on them right away. Just don't let this interfere with your mission.
We won't forget this, General.
I'll let you know if we learn anything. Garza out.
There. If Zane manages to one-up Garza, I'll eat my rifle. Still no word on the Deadeyes' location. I checked with Garza, but she hasn't had any luck decrypting those coordinates we sent her. This is taking too long. For all we know, the Imperials have relocated the Deadeyes. That intel could be obsolete.
We can still pick up a new trail if we follow those coordinates.
I suppose you're right. I'll keep monitoring the Hollow. Maybe something will turn up. Good news, sir. Garza's people decoded the first portion of those coordinates.
Data points to an Imperial excavation site on Tatooine. Looks like my former XO, Torv, is being held there.
Why are the Imperials taking prisoners to such a remote location?
We knew the Imps were anxious to work the Deadeyes to death. Can't think of a harsher, more miserable place than Tatooine. We'll know more once we find Torv. He just better have some answers for us.
On your feet, soldiers.
Lieutenant Jorgen? What are you doing here?
I'm getting you out of here.
Thought we'd have been out of here weeks ago. Who's this?
I'm the commander of Havoc Squad.
Havoc Squad? It's an honor, sir.
Okay, enough boot-kissing. I want answers, Torv. For starters, how'd you get yourselves captured?
It's all there in our mission outline. Didn't Zane brief you?
Zane? As in Senior Agent Zane?
Man's been nothing but trouble for us.
So he didn't... Oh, Then I'm afraid I can't say anything more. SIS orders.
What does the SIS have to do with this?
That's classified, sir.
Out with it, soldier. We're not leaving until we get some answers.
But we... Okay, look, we let ourselves get caught. Part of some top-secret SIS op. They implanted tracking devices in us. Plan was to follow us through Imperial space, find out where the imps ship their POWs, and then come rescue us.
Looks like someone forgot to follow through with that last part.
Nobody anticipated the imps would split us up, send us to labor details. Surprised the SIS didn't spring us then.
Typical SIS.
Should have known better than to trust those spooks.
Too good an opportunity. You know how many troops we have in those camps.
What if the Imperials had executed you?
Things wouldn't have been so bad if the SIS had held up their end of the plan.
Got that right. A good soldier never leaves a man behind. We'll have it out with the SIS later. For now, just sit tight. I'll call for an evac, get you boys home. Well, they're off. The SIS better have a good reason for leaving those men behind.
Zane is involved. Maybe he wants to enlighten us.
I'm sure he'll have something to say about this rescue op of ours.
Anyway, we've done all we can for now. I'll see about getting the rest of those coordinates decrypted.
I ever tell you about the time we were ordered to take out Moff Dallum? Dangerous, Mark. Wily is the... Hang on. Incoming transmission. Care to guess who it is?
Major, Senior Agent Zane here. Apparently, I didn't make myself clear earlier. Or perhaps you thought an unauthorized rescue mission wouldn't constitute as interfering?
Can it, Zane? Torv told us all about your involvement in the Deadeye's capture.
Considering how incredibly classified that information was, I do hope you had to torture Lieutenant Torv. I understand your concern for your comrades, but you morons are only complicating things.
You're addressing the commander of Havoc Squad, Zane. You will show him the proper respect.
Apologies, but this is a delicate operation and your continued involvement will only jeopardize its completion.
We could have worked together if you'd kept us in the loop.
I would have if this had been any of your business.
Your operation's falling apart, Zane. Now either rescue the Deadeyes yourself or get out of the way.
I don't take orders from grunts. This mission is over when I say it is.
I've had it with this guy. Permission to cut him off, sir.
Permission granted.
Good riddance. I can't tell if he really dropped the ball on this one or if he's still just lying to us. Either way, the SIS had their chance. Time for Havoc Squad to get the job done right. I may have been wrong about you. Takes a lot to lead a squad like Havoc. Wasn't convinced you had it in you. Thought you were inexperienced, untested. But you've got good instincts. Turned out to be a first-class leader.
That means a lot coming from you, Jorgen.
I just call it like I see it. I'll admit, that business on Ord Mantell still irks me. But it landed me in the most elite squad in the Republic, under one of the finest commanders I've served with. So I can't complain too much. Just got off the hollow with Torv. He asked me to thank you for getting him out of that labor camp. He's starting to see the danger the other Deadeyes are in. Anxious for us to find them.
We could use him when we rescue the rest of the Deadeyes.
SIS already has him tied up in debriefs. Pretty much exchanged one cell for another. It was a mistake to trust a snake like Zane, but Torv's heart was in the right place. I just hope this mistake doesn't get any of those men killed.
Outstanding news, sir. We've got a positive fix on the Deadeye's location. Garza's people just finished decrypting the coordinates we sent them. The data points to an Imperial outpost on Hoth. Another labor camp, most likely.
Let's get down there and bring those soldiers home.
Right behind you, sir. Once we get those men out of there, we can put all this craziness behind us. I just hope we're not too late. Barracks. Hal. You two still breathing?
More or less. Didn't expect to see you here, sir.
Nor I. Care to tell me what you two are doing here?
We're rescuing the Deadeyes. Play nice and maybe we'll let you tag along.
Maybe I don't want to be rescued. Don't you get it? This operation was never about rescuing POWs. We've been after one thing, Dusk 9.
Impossible. That place is just a myth.
Is it? We'll never know now, thanks to you two.
If that's true, then you lied to the Deadeyes about their mission's real objective.
Of course. We could hardly expect a bunch of grunts to keep their mouths shut. Next to the Emperor's location, Dusk Nine is the Empire's best-kept secret. Hundreds of Black Ops projects are born there.
It's also a prison, according to the rumors. The things that supposedly go on there, too horrible to be real.
We're more interested in the intel hoarded there. We seeded thousands of bugged soldiers into the Imperial penal system, hoping for a bite.
Why so many soldiers?
To improve our odds, naturally. The more soldiers we seed, the better our chances of someone winding up at Dusk Nine. We were using the wrong bait. The brass at Dusk Nine weren't interested in common soldiers. But how could they resist an SIS agent? So, I bugged myself, staged a bogus rescue operation, and let myself be captured. I was awaiting transfer when you two geniuses showed up.
If you had kept us in the loop, we could have coordinated this better.
And what? Hope you wouldn't say anything? Now, I have no choice but to abort my mission and try again somewhere else.
Sir, we can deal with Zane later. Let's just find the rest of the squad and get out of here.
Jorgen, sir, they're dead. The cold... they didn't make it.
What? Trace? Coplin? They're gone? But I thought... Zane.
Take it easy, Jorgen.
Stay out of this, sir.
You killed them. You promised them a rescue that never came, and now they're dead for it.
How many other soldiers have died for you? Huh? 100? 1,000?
You can't kill me, Jorgen. Too many witnesses.
As far as we're concerned, sir, the Imperials killed him.
What? Wait, you can't just... Major, do something!
Put the gun down, Jorgen. Zane has a lot to answer for, but this isn't the way.
Fine. He's not worth it anyway.
Much obliged. As for you, you think you can pull a blaster on me and walk away? I'll see you in prison for that.
You'll have every soldier in the Republic gunning for you if this gets out.
Right. Consider my lips sealed.
Let's get these men back to their squad. I'll call for an evac. They're off, sir. Mission accomplished.
I know it was hard, but you did the right thing.
Honestly, I'd rather not talk about it right now, sir. Let's just get out of here. Sir, I'd like to apologize for my behavior earlier. When I heard about Trace and Coplin, I just lost it. Would have done something stupid if you hadn't stopped me.
Losing a friend is no easy thing.
I can accept it when a comrade falls in battle, but those men were sold out. I'd have been no better than Zane if I pulled that trigger. I'd just be another thug doing whatever it took to get his way.
You're a good soldier, Jorgen. Don't forget that.
Thank you, sir. There's always going to be men like Zane calling the shots in the Republic. Can't kill all of them. Better to work with the system than against it.
The Republic needs more soldiers like you. You'll make it to the top someday.
Don't know that I'll ever trust the brass again. But I trust you, sir. You kept me from making the biggest mistake of my life. I won't forget that. Whatever happens, just know that I'll always have your back, sir. I'm a Havoc man to the end. You can count on me to train any recruits we might get. Give me a couple days, I can show any rookie how to handle a rifle properly.